Hey guys, today I am watching while Butter is the world's only rat-free place with humans. By half is interesting, so let's get into it. I've heard Alberta is rat-free, and I've heard Saskatchewan is also pretty much rat-free, like almost rat-free as well. So, you know, good stuff.
The map of,
and obviously rats aren't really native, they come from Europe as well, so interesting.
All the people in the world who don't live in Alberta, Canada. Interestingly, you can see the only place in the world that doesn't have people who don't live in Alberta, Canada is Alberta, Canada. More interestingly though, this is nearly identical to the map of all the places in the world that are swarming with rats. Also pretty much everywhere except for Alberta, Canada. These rats spread disease, they destroy property, and worst of all, they take control of impressionable young French chefs and force them to cook a dish that's basically just soggy vegetables. They're one of mankind's most persistent and damaging plagues. So how did Alberta manage to avoid them? Well, in order to explain why there aren't rats in Alberta, you need to understand why there are rats, well, everywhere else. You see, much like Asian carp, Burmese pythons, and James Corden, rats aren't native to North America, but their presence in our ecosystem has proved equally destructive.
Brought them with the colonization, damn. Yep, Europeans brought them over, unfortunately. But you know, you could bring over. You could subscribe to the channel and like this video. That would really help out. Yeah, bad segue, but let's get back to the video.
Common rat actually originated somewhere around Mongolia and began to quickly spread to other parts of the world after the Middle Ages. The shift from wooden structures to brick buildings, and our propensity to fill those brick buildings with cheese, made it easy for rats to take shelter in climates outside their natural habitat, so long as there were human structures there to shelter them. Once a few rats got settled in one of these new climates, they became nearly impossible to remove. A single pair of rats can multiply to about 15,000 in about a year. When the Industrial Revolution rolled around, we started building a lot more brick buildings and filling them with a lot more cheese, and the rats were able to spread to every single corner of the Earth, except for the bonus continent, Antarctica, a few Arctic islands, and Alberta. Originally, Alberta's rat-free status was thanks to a little variable I call the no one wants to live there factor. Since modern rats are almost completely dependent on humans to support them, this factor did all the heavy lifting until the 1910s, when starting a barley farm in the middle of nowhere became all the rage. Alberta's other natural defense is its unique geography. On three sides of its border, it's surrounded by a hefty buffer of hostile landscapes. To the west, you've got the Rocky Mountains, where rats can't survive the harsh high-altitude conditions or lease a decent four-wheeler. To the south, you've got the high plains of Montana, which are too sparsely populated and generally depressing for rats to make it very far. To the north, you've got cold. That leaves the southern section of its eastern border, adjacent to Saskatchewan, where rats could possibly invade. And though it only took my writer like 10 minutes of reading Alberta's government website to figure that out, it took the rats until the summer of 1950 to finally find Alberta's weak spot. When the first few rats were spotted crossing Alberta's border, the government acted quickly. After all, they were already calling themselves, quote, the only rat-free area in North America, and they weren't ready to invest the money in a more enticing tourism slogan. Instead, they established a rat control zone along their eastern border. Originally, the rat control zone was really more of a giant poisoned farmland zone, with Alberta's government dumping 140,000 pounds or 65,000 kilograms of arsenic trioxide onto all of the farms along the border with Saskatchewan. This led to the deaths of countless farm animals and pets, so naturally the government discontinued the program for costing too much money. Today's program involves a publicly funded team of rat inspectors and assassins who annually inspect every single farm and building in the control zone, upwards of 4,000 premises depending on the year. Now, if you moved to the rat control zone because you thought it sounded like an exotic getaway, you're in for a rough surprise. It's actually a zone where rats are controlled. And by controlled, I mean trapped, gas baited, or in more extreme cases, dug out with a bulldozer. Now, Sam, you might be saying, surely there are other ways for rats to get into Alberta. After all, you make all those videos about transportation and planes and stuff. Well, to that I say, stop confusing me for that logistics nerd. Like, who even watches videos about logistics, really? What a waste of time. But to that I also say, yes, good point. Alberta's rat-controlling measures do extend beyond just the rat control zone. Firstly, Albertans are banned from owning rats, even domesticated fancy rats, as pets. Only zoos, universities, and certain research facilities are permitted to possess rats. If a rat were to sneak in on a truck or a plane, there's an active hotline, 310-RATS, and an email address, established last year because email is complicated, where any concerned Albertan can report a rat sighting to the government, who then investigates it thoroughly. Though Alberta gets hundreds of these reports every year, most of them turn out to...
Does Alberta have mice? I mean, mice and rats are pretty similar. I guess they watch out for those as well.
To be squirrels or muskrats or a mafioso who was caught wearing a wire. Only a tiny fraction turn out to be the real deal, and those cases get heavy news coverage. Or a 6-minute YouTube video explaining why a rat in Alberta is somehow exceptional. Now, being free of rats isn't the only advantage of living in this giant swath of frozen farmland. Albertans also have access to Canadian Netflix. I mean, they've got Pulp Fiction.
Bruh. Alright, this was enjoyable and informative. Let's check out some of the comments down below. This is literally the one thing we have going for us here. I live in Calgary. It went from negative 40 to 40 Celsius in 6 months. God damn. Literally so true, literally. Best economy per capita, highest educated, highest HDI, best provincial healthcare, lowest cost of living of the major cities, but yeah, dumb redneck province. Not even sure. Gonna refer to Antarctica as the bonus continent forever now. yeah, of course Antarctica, it's an icy desert. Yeah, as someone from Alberta, I can confirm I don't know what a rat is. The rat population in my city actually slowed down during the pandemic lockdown. Their main found source, leftovers from restaurant, was suddenly gone. So the rats resorted to cannibalism. The rats were then easily hunted by stray cats for being skinny and weak. Good shit. The cats when seeing the rats. Pathetic. This led to the deaths of countless farm animals and pets. So naturally the government discontinued the program for costing too much money. Came here looking for comments about how Alberta had rats and they were called politicians and was not disappointed. Wow. This guy sounds a lot like the lame logistics person Wind of a Productions. The video was so family-friendly and friendly. When Alberta loses in a rat-free province, it gains a rat-infested legislature. I like how 90% of the footage of Alberta is just Canmore. My mom tried to convince me to not leave Alberta, mostly by saying, they have rats out east, you know. Well, if you go to Saskatchewan, not many rats, I think, as well. She's talking about Ottawa, right? Yeah. Oh, yeah, the capital, In my first year in Montreal, I made the mistake of leaving a door open that led to the back alley of my apartment building. Found a rat on my kitchen counter that was eating my fucking bagels. Damn, bro, damn. Oh yeah, bagels in Montreal aren't bad. Still better bagels than New York, but yeah, fair enough. I mean, because New York practically invented bagel. I mean, it's a New York thing and just spread out. But yeah, Montreal bagels aren't bad either. Damn, Alberta looking thick in that map projection. In Calgary, a city of 1 to 1.5 million in Alberta. It was front page news a few years ago when 5 rats were found in an alley. Name any other city like that, except Edmonton, also in Alberta. Well, 6 rats in an alley is even news. I heard Calgary was nice enough. Anyway, this was a pretty fun video. If you enjoyed my reaction, please like this video and subscribe to the channel. Thank you so much for watching, and bye-bye.